Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pastaya Bhutale Shimati Bhakti Vedanta Swamini Tanamane. Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pacharane Nivaseja Sanyavari Prasatya Deva Satarane. Vanshakalpa Tuvyascha Kripa Sindhu Vayavacha Patitanam Pavinevyo Vaishnavevyo Namo Nama. Hare Krishna. I would like to speak something about His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Maharaj. It's a very difficult thing. At the moment, he's still in this world, but it doesn't seem like for very long. But how can I speak about someone who I've known for 40 years? He was there in Vrindavan when I first went to Vrindavan in 1983, and we've been friends ever since then. But I'll try to say something, and what I will say is probably quite shallow compared to this very devoted, devotional, strong, special, extremely special devotee, Kadamba Kanana Maharaj. He was a genius, or he is a genius, practically speaking. He spoke so many languages. He spoke Indian languages. Spoke Bengali, Hindi, spoke European languages, so many. And I have some notes here. And he was so intelligent, both managerially. He was very, very, very strong. When he was speaking to me last time, we were speaking just as friends, and suddenly he put on his managerial hat and his eyes shined, and he gave me some managerial advice. And then he took off his managerial hat and his eyes became quite soft. But he was managerially and strategically very astute. But not only that, he had such penetrating Shastric spiritual intelligence as well. And he was so concerned, and he helped so many devotees. And when he gave someone shelter, he really gave them shelter. But he was so Shastrically astute, and he especially was a devotee to one special book, the Chaitanya Charitamrita. He told me he had thousands of lecture notes on the Chaitanya Charitamrita, and he was in the process of writing a book about Chaitanya Charitamrita. And he said that that you cannot worship Radha and Krishna separately from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and you cannot worship Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu separately from Radha and Krishna. He was very fixed and very devoted. He had such a sense of the overview and the subtleties of Chaitanya Charitamrita. He was very absorbed in it. Chaitanya Charitamrita, in many senses, was his life. I brought out something from Chaitanya Charitamrita, just a few verses and one short purport by Srila Prabhupada. This is from after Mahaprabhu took sannyas. As he's traveling, he says the verse of the Avanti Brahmana from the 23rd chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam in Uddhava Gita. Tan se astaya paratmanishtam adyasitam purvatamara mahadabir aham trishami dharatya param tamo mukundadri naseva yaiva. So this verse means, it defines, Mahaprabhu was very, very fond of this verse because it defined the mood of a sannyasi. I shall cross over the insurmountable ocean of nescience by being firmly fixed in the service of the lotus feet of Krishna. This was approved by the previous acharyas, this being firmly fixed in the lotus feet of Krishna as the method of transcendence. It was approved by the previous acharyas who were fixed in firm devotion to the Lord, the Paramatma, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then Mahaprabhu says, he approves of the purport of this verse on account of the determination of the mendicant devotee to engage in the service of Lord Mukunda. He was a Tridandi sannyasi. Mahaprabhu gave his approval of this verse, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says, indicating that it was very good. because of his mood of determined seva. And then the next verse says, Paratmanishtam matravesha dharana. The real purpose of accepting sannyas is to dedicate oneself to the service of Mukunda. By serving Mukunda, one can actually be liberated from the bondage of material existence. So Srila Prabhupada explains in his purport that the sannyas dress, and our Kadamba Kanamaraj was a sannyasi, a strong sannyasi. The sannyas dress is actually an attraction for material formality. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not like such formality, but he wanted the essence of it. And that essence is service to Mukunda. Such determination in any condition is paratmanishtam. That is required. Focused, determined determination in the service of the Lord. The conclusion is that the sannyas order depends not on the dress, but on the determination to serve Mukunda. So this really speaks of the great excellence of Kadamba Kanamaraj. He was so determined. He was so fixed in the service of Mukunda, in the service of the lotus feet of Mukunda. He was fixed, so fixed in the service of his Guru Maharaj, His Holiness Jayadvaita Maharaj. He was fixed in that service in a very mature, affectionate, friendly, but determined and surrendered way. He told me one time that his Guru Maharaj, His Holiness Jayadvaita Maharaj, had told him he shouldn't play guitar anymore. And he was an expert guitarist. And he was sort of saying, oh, why did he say that? But he never, ever played guitar again. Instead, he used his musical talent, his musical artistic talent in kirtan, and became glorious in that way. He was so surrendered. When his Guru Maharaj told him to take sannyas immediately, he immediately took sannyas. He was determined to write his book on Chaitanya Charitamrita, and his Guru Maharaj said, you go to New York and you head up the preaching there and organize things there in the Brooklyn Temple. He immediately left that. His spiritual master told him to begin accepting disciples. It wasn't his desire, but he immediately did that. He was fixed, determinedly fixed, surrendered to his guru, and so surrendered to Srila Prabhupada and his mission. He loved Prabhupada. He had such deep veneration for Prabhupada. And because of that, he had determination, fixed determination in Prabhupada's mission. And he would do anything for Prabhupada in his mission. He did so many amazing things. He headed the construction, much of the construction for Prabhupada's Pushpa Samadhi in Sridhar Mayapur. He helped the Spain Yatra, the Spanish Yatra, when it was in great need. He helped the Vrindavan Temple when it was in great need. He preached in South Africa. I'll speak in a few moments of his preaching in South Africa. But he was so determined. That is what I would like to say. He told me just a few days ago that I promised that I'm going to chant 16 rounds a day, and I'm going to die with my hands in my beanbag chanting those 16 rounds. He was just so fixed and so determined. He was so strong-minded. He wasn't just surrendered and fixed, and he was so strong-minded, being an independent-minded Dutchman. One Dutchman from Amsterdam told me, we Dutchmen, we don't like dogs. We like cats. So Kadamba Kanamaraj, he was so strong and independent-minded. And yet, and that fits so well with his determination. But he wasn't just determined in that way. He was so soft and so compassionate as well. He told me that he went to Soweto, which is a very difficult, poor suburb, black suburb in South Africa. And he told me he had been preaching there for some time, and then there was a revolution amongst the people there. and they surrounded him, and it was quite dangerous, he said. He said, there, one's life can be worth nothing, practically speaking. So people who were antagonistic surrounded him, and they said to him, what are you doing here? What's your purpose here? You're not a black person. What is your purpose here? And he said, with complete honesty, and not something just superficial to convince them of something and get himself out of a dangerous position, he said to them with complete honesty and earnestness, and he fully carried this forward in his life, he said, my forefathers, they came to your country and they exploited the land. They made you into their servants. They raped your wives. And now I've come to try to pay back some of that debt. And indeed, he did do that. He was the kind of person that appreciated something that that Bhavananda had done for him. When he had joined ISKCON Krishna Balaram Mandir in the 80s in Vrindavan, Bhavananda had seen that he had leadership qualities, and he gave him all facility. He saw the potential in this person, and he expressed, Kadamba Kanana Maharaj expressed appreciation for that. And that same principle about seeing potential in people and then helping them and empowering them was so much a part of Kadamba Kanana Maharaj's his managerial expertise, and also a part of his compassion. So in South Africa, he understood that these people have great potential. So he served them. He started a fund to put some of these potentially great leaders in through the university. And now, very much because of his leadership, he's so trusted, because he was so trustworthy, and he did things fully with determination, with a full heart, and with full sincerity. He didn't do things halfway. So because of that, today there are so many very well-educated, intelligent, great African leaders, and they're the future in South Africa in so many ways. So because that was the brilliant vision and pure-heartedness, pure soft-heartedness of Kadamba Kanana Maharaj. And I respect that so much, and I respect those leaders who he nurtured and helped them gain everything that they needed to lead Krishna consciousness in South Africa into the future. So he was determined. He was soft-hearted and so intelligent as well. I would like to speak a little bit more about his deep spirituality and his love for Chaitanya Charitamrita. This was clearly his favorite book. And because I recently during the COVID times, was studying Chaitanya Charitamrita as the book I was studying, hoping that one day I would be able to teach it, because I learn best when I'm studying and preparing and teaching. So I have been studying it for 2 years, and he and I would speak about it, and he had such deep understandings. He had an understanding of the flow of the philosophy. He had understandings of subtleties in Mahaprabhu's presentation that were always very enlivening for me. He was someone I could really speak to about Chaitanya Charitamrita and the glories of Kaviraj Goswami, but he had studied it far more deeply than me. He had studied the context in which it was spoken in. He had studied how it was spoken about from the academic point of view, from other points of view, from the historical point of view. And in this way, he had entered so deeply into the spirit of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And what was that spirit of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? It was simultaneously two things that's described in the beginning of Adi Lila in chapters 3 and 4. It was deeply, deeply relishing Vrindavan and the pastimes of Sisi, Radha, and Krishna in Vrindavan. And it was also spreading that message of Krishna consciousness through the holy names, through the books, and through the method of actually preaching Krishna consciousness. So let me just take a look at my notes over here and see if there was anything that I really wanted to say that I didn't say. Intelligent, managerially, shastrically, spoke so many languages, practically speaking, a genius, a true leader, such a true leader, so surrendered to Guru, to Srila Prabhupada and Prabhupada's mission. And what can I say? A person one could really open one's heart to, a person who is very real, not pretentious at all. He was just such a friend, such a leader, and such a wonderful, determined sannyasi, and such a kind-hearted devotee. We will miss him, certainly, and what a glorious person. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.